Hey guys, well, I don't know about you guys, but I am already bored. I am so desperate to fly. It just seems to me that, you know, COVID-19, I'm a week or so into it, I'm stuck at home, and it's boring as hell. I just want to go and get one of my wings or something around here and actually get out and fly, but that ain't going to happen. So, never one to complain, I came up with an option, and it's called a toothpick. Now, the great thing about the toothpick is it can fly around my garden just like a whoop, but give me a 5-inch feel. But being who I am, I never do half measures. So first off, this thing has crossfire on it. Brilliant. It can go blimmin' miles. And then what I did, I rigged up something slightly different. So I actually had an iteration of this a long time ago, which in previous videos you'll have seen that I did, but I've extended and improved it somewhat. So essentially what I've got is I've got a docking with a rapid fire sitting on it and two TrueRC crosshairs. Now these are fantastic antennas, and at the angles that I got them mounted, you get a fantastic near 360 coverage and very, very high gain. And then you'll notice something different. There's a little job. So internally, I popped this all open and I got an Immersion RC Tramp antenna. It's one of those which you use, well, not an antenna, a VTX. You can use the RFID sort of TNR wand to update it. And I've completely fitted it internally within the docking. There's enough room to do it. And I've repurposed the power switch on the docking over here to turn it on and off, so I don't have to use it. But the long and short, what this does, it gives me a wireless relay, which is fantastic. But, you know, again, one step further is I've got a TNR wand, which has a firmware that I got from Tony Cake. And this is not something publicly available. So if you guys want it, you're going to have to ask him for it. It's not for me to give out. But what's great is it allows me to set the VTX to operate on low band. Now, to give you a sense of what that means, I listen on Raceband that I'm receiving on, which is on about 5,600 as Raceband 1, or 5,632 I think it might be, but I'm relaying on closer to 5,300, which is a long way away, and on a tiny little 10 milliwatt feed off a superb antenna. And the result is that there's absolutely no interference or crosstalk between the receiver and the relay, which is great because my rapid fire can tune into that. Now, because it's wireless and I get sort of say 10 meters range with this thing, I plug it up on my shed roof and then I get even better picture quality. It's honestly, it's a fantastic way of doing it, and I think I'm going to convert all of my ground stations, my trackers and everything, to operate off a similar wireless relay. But yeah, that's what I've been up to. I thought I'd show you a quick flight of just the picture quality flying around my property. It really is very, very good considering that this thing's pushing out only on 25 milliwatt. And let me know what you think. I think it's a great idea. If you want more details, I can always tear this down and show the soldering inside if it's of any interest. You know, up to you guys. Cheers, enjoy.